King's Quest V walkthrough. Yes, the beginning from Across the Universe by Fiona Apple. Like, it's not by Fiona Apple, it's from the Beatles, but I like her remix. A lot of people complain about that too much, but hey. Anyways, here we go. And we're outside of Crispinifer's or Crispin's cabin, and I walk to the water. Watch out, a poisonous snake! Right now, we're headed into town because, you know, I need to get stuff. If you go to town, I'll wait here for you. I had a nasty run-in with the dog once, and... Oh, it hurt. I guess it must have hurt. Wow. Busy place. May I help you, sir? That's the voice I always pictured for the shopkeeper. It's kind of weird looking too in the NES version. We're outside again. That old guy needed to disappear because I think he drops that coin. So I'm gonna take it, even though I know it belongs to him. That's right, this game teaches you the fundamentals of life. Bending down quickly, Graham retrieves the coin. Now we're gonna get a fish in a barrel. You know, the expression shooting fish in a barrel kind of thing. This game really does play on expressions and fables and stuff. See, we get an old fish. He notices the old fish. Well, I hope he takes it. Yeah, he took it. Well, as in this game, it's essential because sometimes you'll see something and it's in a cupboard or something and you gotta take it. You know, so you have to choose different options. You end up taking the wrong thing, you know, and that kind of blows. Now we're going to this pie shop here. Pie! I'll wait for you out here, Graham. Hoo-hoo. And that's the pie man. Why can't he be the muffin man? The muffin man rocks. Talking to yourself again? Yeah. That's how I feel when I do this. Open the thingy-majigger, and... Okay, this game is really slow right now. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on, come on, come on! Open, open! Okay. And go to the right, get a silver coin. Give it to the guy that's eating in front of his customers in his own restaurant. The pie cost $1 coin each. One silver coin each. Why I think dollar? Maybe it's because I need money for the holidays. I got it right here. Here you go. I hope you enjoy your custard pie. Oh, I'm sure I will. I think, like, Link would sound like Graham if he talked. Maybe. Look, I mean, in a restaurant, you don't have a cat there. Or in a bakery present. I mean, that would, like, take away customers. It's kind of unsanitary. At my old job, I worked in a bagel shop, and, like, if I ever got caught, or if anybody ever got caught eating in front of a customer like that, you'd get canned immediately. Although, like, people would sneak around for all the time at my job. It was hilarious. Watch out for the bear, Graham! This is why we're gonna use a fish. You know, a sign in parks like "Don't feed the bears." You know, those are good signs to pay attention to. I wouldn't go near a bear, not unless I had a terminal disease and I wish to die that way. If I do have it, if I did have a terminal disease, I think I would like to go out with a bang. I don't know what I'd do, but I'll come up with. I'm cooking up a something. And, come on, Mr. Bear.
God, that sound was annoying.
The NES, like, no offense to the people who did the NES version, like, I think they did a pretty good job as far as, the graphics go. Here, I gotta read this one.
I am Queen Beatrice, kind sir. I wish to thank you ever so much for saving our hive from the claws of that horrible bear. In return, I offer you a luscious honeycomb from our hive. Please feel free to retrieve one. I promise my bees won't harm you.
I guess, yeah, I can get free honey. Slurpee. Slurpees are good. And we got honey. Well, I guess we didn't. Damn it! Okay, I got it. Frustrating when I forget how to use the controls. See, I'm a poor excuse for a gamer. Who forgets their controls? I have faileth as thine gamer. There's a stick. And go whack somebody with it. In this part, you gotta use a stick on the dog, so leave the ants alone. They'll repay a favor. Cause insects in this game have kings and queens. Just like fairy tales do. I had my English professor throughout the beginning of this entire semester. He's been doing mental masturbation to the entire class. It's hilarious. With the ant and the grasshopper, who is willful or responsible? I just don't give a damn. Here, boy. Go, doggy, go. I have a dog that looks like that. Go get run over by a carriage. Dun, dun, dun. I love the music on this part. Allow me to introduce myself. I'm King Anthony the Great. May I ask, who are you? Why, certainly. I'm King Graham of Daventry, and this is my friend Cedric. We're seeking a way to cross the great mountains to the other ocean on the other side. That is a very perilous undertaking. I wish you would reconsider, but if you shall not, in return for rescuing our home from that flea-bitten cur, I wish to offer you our help, if perchance you may ever need it. Will do. Thank you very much, King Anthony. Cedric and I appreciate your kind offer. We look forward to meeting you again. They're gonna hold the ant to his word, huh? King Graham looks weird in this game. That's to be expected, you know. That's to be expected. Come on! I want the control of my... Yeah. Our control's acting a little funny there, so... Doing... See, it's kind of weird. Oh, Yeah, we're going to the gypsies, tramps, and thieves carriage over there. I'm gonna see if I can talk to this guy. I think you can talk to him sometimes. The sullen man doesn't look like the conversational sort. Well, that sucks. Next, we're gonna go, in the next walkthrough, we're gonna go to the desert where you can really die a lot and timing is everything. So, if you follow it exactly as I say, you come with me if you want to leave. That kind of thing, you know? Where's my puka cursor? Right there! Let's do a little dance. Anyways, stupid desert. Anyways, we're gonna end it here, and I hope you all enjoyed this walkthrough. Please comment and stuff, and I'll hope to see you next time. Bye.